Hi guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we're going to look at the Stealth WA2916G series. Stealth is your high-end luxury toy hauler. This has a 16-foot carrying capacity for your toys. It has a built-in solar panel, built-in generator, fiberglass exterior. Let me show you some of those features. To start off, Stealth's construction is bar none one of the best built toy haulers in the RV industry. One of the reasons for that is because of their short outriggers. Now what those are is they have these little Z-frame outriggers is what they're called, and it's basically how far you're going to extend beyond the I-beam. So you can imagine if you have a bowling ball and you put it on your hand out here, you can only hold it for so long before your arm would get tired. But if you have it up close, you could hold it for a lot longer. That's the same idea what they're applying right here. These are only an 11-inch outrigger compared to a lot of the competition that is doing a 22-inch outrigger. To start off, you'll notice this is all metal instead of plastic here. This is metal instead of plastic here, what you hook your door into. Triple entry step, large grab assist handle, keyless entry. The Arctic package is huge as well, especially here in Colorado. We specifically option ours with those just because we know people are going to want to use them in some of the colder weather, as well as that extra insulation helps you keep the unit a lot cooler during the summertime as well. So this is the ramp door that goes down. You'll notice that these edges, I can't put this down right now because we have another camper in the way, but you'll notice how these corners are radius corners, which is nice because that means you can put the rubber inseam inside there as a one piece instead of having to do three pieces, which can cause leaks, of course. Another thing you'll notice is their construction. They build that out away from the top of the wall so that if it starts to rain, rain's gonna drip down on the outside and not into the inside of your coach. Another thing that you'll like is these locks. These are a much nicer locking system than a lot of the other kinds out there. This has the spring assist, so it makes it very easy so that one person can lift this door up and down as well. This guy does have the built-in fuel station, so you would fill your fuel right here, and then your fuel pump is right here to fill up your toys. And then the other cool feature that you'll really like is this ladder that's built into it, which is important if you have a slide out, but two, it's important that this ladder is the kind that just folds out. So instead of having to have the kind that you have to push on here and then store it inside your garage, this one can just store away to the side very easily. This is a gas electric hot water heater. The cool thing about these gas electric hot water heaters is it will recover super fast. It's a hybrid between a tankless and a normal tank one. It'll give you up to 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour. This guy is your outside shower, so you can pull this guy out and get more or less cord that you need. Has both hot and cold water running to it, and then this is just your city water connection. Over here we have your Onan Cummins Onan 4.0 generator. You have a 30 amp system on this guy, so this can run your air conditioner, your microwave, all your lights, charge your battery, things like that. And the Onans are known to be super reliable over a long time. The other really nice thing about this is the EVAP series. So that means what it'll do is it will drain the carburetor from its fuel so it doesn't oxidize or tarnish your carburetor over time. This guy weighs about 8,500 pounds dry, can handle about 3,500 pounds worth of weight. All LED lights on the front. This is 40 mil aluminum front, so it's very heavy duty, as well as kind of a corrugated look to this bottom half for your rock chips flying up into the underbelly of that. Underneath here, you have two 30-pound propane tanks, so you can switch from one tank over to the other with this easy access deal here. And then this is a power tongue jack. This does have a light on the front here, as well as a second LED light over here so that you can see what you're doing if you're pulling into your campsite, not in the daytime. Over here, you'll notice there's a huge amount of storage compartment. This is your 30 amp cord that comes with the unit, as well as a light here that you can see to be able to see what you're doing as you're getting in and out of here. Second door entry into your bedroom, which is super nice. And then I wanted to point out that this power awning is adjustable. So if you wanted this side or that side for the water to run to, you can do that by adjusting these arms. Black tank sewer flush is already built into it. You'll notice the awning has the nice LED light strip all the way across and the outside speakers. Let's go ahead and check out some features on the inside. Inside the 2916G series, by the way, that G series is an option that you can get with Stealth. That means you get the kicker audio system, the fiberglass exterior, the nicer rims, and then the Arctic package is a separate package that we do for the enclosed underbelly, 12 volt heat pads, Aluma foil insulation to give you that better heat. Back here, I wanted to show you, so this is your garage area. This actually all goes up to the ceiling so that you have plenty of clearance to get your bigger toys in here. You'll notice that even with these all the way up, you could get even things with a large rack on top. This is a ladder that comes with it that you can use. And then this has the screen wall, tent wall in the back as well. And then also this guy folds into a bed. The other cool thing about this one is back here on the back side here, you have a seat cushion as well. That's nice if you're tailgating and let's say you're going to watch the race or something like that, and or you just wanted to have your back deck out and have a place to sit. You have it. So, and then this material is super thick and tough as well. So it just seems like it would stand the test of time. Same material is on the couch and the chairs here, but these are lightweight so that you can pick them up if you need to take them outside, move them somewhere, so that you'd have basically the nicest swivel rockers in the campsite for camp chairs. These tables also move out of the way, so the way this guy works is these poles come out, and this guy you'll put somewhere, and then this guy does turn into a bed as well. So the way that works, folds flat, lifts up, and then these legs fold off to the sides. This guy just buckles right here on both sides. Usually, that's how it works. And then this carpet is just laid here. So if you eventually, let's say you get this carpet and it starts to look gross, it's not hard to get rid of the carpet. If you're bringing your toys in here, obviously you can roll that carpet up and not have to worry about getting junk all over your carpet. Some other cool features. This is the kicker audio system. So it's a touchscreen deal. And it's just push buttons, works super easy. It also has the built-in microphone so that if you wanted to hook up to your Bluetooth phone, you can do that as well. These are the pins that hold the bed up. So say you wanted to put this guy all the way up to the ceiling so it's not in the way, you can do that by using these pins. Otherwise, it's an electric bed system that you control all from inside this spot right here. So this is your command center here. So you have the ability to control your slide out room, your beds up and down right here. This is your awning. You can start your Onan generator from inside your coach, your water pump right here, the electric side of your water heater, the gas side of your water heater, as well as the fuel station button is inside instead of out, which is kind of nice. So that way nobody's pushing your fuel station button on the outside and taking some fuel that they shouldn't. There's also an emergency cutoff switch on the outside too if you need it. Over here we have the battery disconnect. So as you can see, this turns off the lights inside the coach so that you don't accidentally drain the power when you turn your battery disconnect off. These are the tank heaters on the tanks themselves. So those are rated down to negative 11 degrees. You can kick those on, and at about 43 degrees, they will automatically kick on to start protecting your tank. And then once it gets above that, it'll automatically shut off. So they're thermostatically controlled. And then this is your control panel for your converter. So these are all your fuses and your breakers right there. And then this has a smoke screen built into it so that if you have a fuse that goes out, it'll light up so you can say, hey, I noticed that I'm missing a fuse, and you're not trying to troubleshoot forever to figure out which fuse popped on you. Over here, you'll notice it's nice solid surface countertops all the way through, pull down sink faucet with the high rise, and it's one big sink, so you can easily put all those big huge pots and pans that you would normally need to clean, you can use them in here. Over here, this is a extra large stainless steel, and these are the cables, by the way, that go to your ramp that goes down, so if you wanted to use as a deck, you can. Little remote for your stereo system, and then this is an 8 cubic foot refrigerator instead of the normal 6 cubic foot refrigerator. So pretty good size on here, a little bit bigger than the industry average. You do have a separate microwave and oven and glass stovetop, so this folds back and makes into a backsplash, as well as gives you that extra counter space since everything is flush on top here. They do give you to work with back here as well. Nice cup drawers, and they even have the spot where it's cut out for the silverware if you need to. And then they have the nice ball bearing glide, so it makes it really easy to work with. Over here you have plenty of cabinet space to work with, so if you needed a pantry, you have it. Over here I wanted to show you that this is the control panel for your solar controller. So this will tell you how full your batteries are, how much sunlight you're getting. You can even switch to what kind of battery you are on. So like right now it's on an AGM battery, so I would switch that over to a wet cell or a flooded cell battery. You also have a little USB port right here, and this is the solar panel that's on top of the roof right now. So this is a 200 watt solar panel that this controller basically will make sure that your battery stays full but not overcharged and doesn't kill your battery by overcharging it. Here inside the bathroom, one of the things I like about this particular configuration is even with the slide-in in, you can still access your refrigerator, you can still access your bathroom, you can still access your bedroom, and you can do that either from the second door entry or even the main door entry, either one. But as you can see, this has the nice glass shower that has plenty of room to move around, lots of headroom to work with. In this neo angled shower, you have a linen closet over on this side, and on top of all the cabinetry in both the kitchen area and the bathroom area, there's a nice thick 2-inch lip, so if you needed to put something up there, you can do it without having to worry if it's going to come crashing down. So another spot, nice medicine cabinet to work with, GFI outlet. So, light switch on the side instead of having to reach all the way up to the ceiling to reach everything. Skylight and a fan, so you have a lot of natural light to work with. As you can see, this bathroom goes all the way just into the bedroom. So you don't have to travel across the camper to get to your bathroom in the middle of the night. And both hanging spots here, again, a nice lip inside here to work with. LED lights throughout the entire camper, so these are gonna run a lot cooler. They're gonna use a fraction of the energy that a normal incandescent light will use. And yeah, pull out drawer here. And then underneath this box is all that storage that we saw from the outside. And now this does lift up if you need extra storage in here as well. Back in the corners here, I'll show you one more thing. This has a 110 outlet over here, as well as another 110 outlet over here. And then in addition to that, you can see that this has a 12 volt outlet as well as USB ports as well. So that's kind of nice to be able to charge your cell phone off your solar panel that you just charged your batteries off of. So pretty cool unit overall. Probably the number one selling floor plan for Stealth. And then Stealth is the number one selling toy hauler, basically the West Coast up to about Colorado or so, because these are built in California. So thanks for joining me on the Stealth WA2916G series. Let us know if you have any questions. Fill out our comments, subscribe. Our Phone number is 970-313-4337. You can ask for me. I'd love to answer any questions for you. Our web address is thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. You can come visit us here in person and see this guy. And our address here is 3511 West Service Road in Evans, Colorado. We're about an hour north of Denver on Highway 85, about 1 mile south of Highway 34. All right, thanks, guys.